strangely, while Sufism seems to be doing better and better in the West, Sufism until quite recently has been having a hard time in the Muslim world. Because during the 19th century, when Islam started to modernize in various fashions as part of the whole modernization process that was going on across the Ottoman Empire and other parts of the Middle East, Sufism became rather less popular because people wanted a nice modern rational Islam, and the nice modern rational Islam didn't include all these difficult abstract ideas that are so important in Sufism. The nice modern rational Islam is what started off as being quite liberal, but then because of things that were going on, especially in foreign policy and so forth, then turned into the Islam of the Muslim Brothers, and is related in some ways to the Salafism that we're all very familiar with today. This Islam of nice, simple, straightforward rules is a version of Islam that has no space for Sufism. And as the nice, clear, logical, rule-based Islam became more and more popular across the Muslim world, Sufism became less and less popular. What's happening now is that there are signs of a Sufi renaissance in the Muslim world, because in the end, the nice, clear, straightforward, rule-based Islam is perhaps not that spiritually satisfying. So in exactly the same way that Westerners went from being religious to being rational, and then found that rationality was sometimes a little bit dry and disappointing, and there developed a new Western interest in spirituality, there are signs that a similar process is going on in the Muslim world, and that people who are finding the Islam of the Salafis and the Islam of the Muslim Brothers, this modernist Islam, a bit unsatisfying spiritually, are turning to Sufism again as an alternative and more satisfying, more spiritually satisfying form of Islam.